I want to start with you. So 17%, big number. But once things reopen, it looks like the yearly drop in our carbon emissions might be at best 7% and potentially just 4%. Walk me through what you found.
First of all, the drop in the United States for a week or two in April was almost a third. So that really is unprecedented. And 4 to 7% for the global year may not sound like much, but that would be the biggest drop since World War II and probably ever. So it really is a massive change. It's for the wrong reasons, and our hearts open to the people who've lost their jobs or loved ones. But we have to learn what we can from this unprecedented and tragic experiment.
So does that mean we're all good and everything's going to be fine because we were able to reduce carbon emissions by that much in this short period of time?
No, certainly not. I mean, we don't want to reduce emissions because people are locked down at home and because 40 million Americans are out of work. I mean, in 2008, the last recession, emissions dropped 1.5% for a year and they shot back up 5% the following year in 2010. So what we really need to do is find a way to make these declines more permanent. And we learned from that. The stimulus funding in 2009 jump-started the wind and solar industry. You know, we've got millions of Americans who work in clean energy. We need the same transformation in the transportation industry. And we can start by freeing up $40 billion in low-cost loans that are sitting idle in the Department of Energy's clean energy and advanced vehicle programs. We need to put that money to work.
Hello, YouTubers. If you're watching this, it means you've checked out our channel, so thank you. Now do me a favor, subscribe by clicking on that button down there. Click on any of the videos to watch the latest interviews and highlights from MTP Daily and MSNBC. You can get more Meet the Press content every morning in the First Read newsletter. If you're tired of content that you don't know anything about where it came from, you don't have to have that problem with us. NBC News, MSNBC, MTP, and the Meet the Press mindset right here for you on YouTube. Subscribe now.